Nice. Did you make that?
No, I traded it for my toaster.
I'm gonna go show Mr. Green.
It sure was a good idea to trade in my truck. It had a broken wheel. Watch this.
Thank you, right, for trading your broken old truck.
But I told him it was broken.
Oh, never mind, Eric. I think we can fix it.
Good. Maybe it wasn't such a good idea. Do you think I should ask for my truck back?
No, Eric. Once you've made a trade, you should stick with it. What would happen if all my customers wanted to bring back the toys they buy?
Well, you could trade them for other toys.
I could. But it's easier if you use money. You know, that's why money was invented.
I don't think so, Mr. Bean. I think it would be a good idea if we didn't use money at all.
Oh, you do, do you? Well, let's see if you're right. Here you are, Debbie. Let's pretend that this is yours. And Eric, you can have the horse.
Thank you, Mr. Bean.
All right. How can you end up with the horse and the rider?
I'll trade. Debbie, would you like to trade?
Okay.
Thank you. Now, see, Mr. Bean? I didn't need any money. Now I have a cowboy.
But you haven't got the horse for him to ride.
Oh.
See, what you need is something else to trade, so you can end up with both the horse and the rider.
How am I going to get something else?
Well, get a job.
A job?
Yes. That's how people get things they don't have. They work for them.
Who's going to give me a job?
I will. Now, you see my tools that are on the table? Well, you bring them over for me and I'll consider that a job. All right?
Okay. Here you go, Mr. Bean.
Thank you. All right, now let's say that I think that that job is worth, $2. But you don't think it's a good idea to use money, so I'll pay you with these two cards.
Thank you, Mr. Bean. Hey, Debbie, I'll trade you two cards for a horse.
No, thank you. I don't like your cards.
But you have to take them.
No, I don't. I don't want your silly car.
Then what do you want?
I'll trade you for Jenny's comb. It's pretty.
But I don't have Jenny's comb.
Too bad.
Hey, Jenny. How would you like to trade these two cars for a comb?
What would I want with those two cards?
I don't know.
Now, if you had a package of pencils, I might be interested.
Mr. Bean, how much does a package of pencils cost?
$2, Eric.
And how much are these cards?
$1 each.
That makes $2 altogether, doesn't it, Mr. Bean? Because $1 and $1 makes $2.
Yes, it is. The two cars cost the same as the package of pencils.
Mr. Bean, will you trade me these two cars for a package of pencils?
Well, I'm afraid not, Eric. You see, I already have too many cars. I don't need any more.
But I can't get the horse back that way, Mr. Bean, because you have the pencils that Jenny wants, and Jenny has the comb that Debbie wants, and Debbie has the horse that I want.
Well, that's too bad, Eric. But I'll tell you what. Why don't you give me back the two cards, and I'll pay you again for the job you did earlier. Only this time, I'll pay you in money.
Okay.
There you are. $2. One, two.
Thank you, Mr. Bean.
See if it helps.
Debbie, will you give me the horse for $2?
Okay. Can I give you $2 for your comb?
Okay.
Bean, how much is a package of pencils?
$2.
I'll take one.
All right.
Thank you.
You see, Eric, how easy money makes things. I've got my $2.
I've got my pencils.
I've got my comb.
And I've got my horse and rider. I guess money isn't such a bad idea after all.
All right. $1, 1 cent. You know how many cents in $1?
100 cents makes a dollar.
Debbie's right. And I've got a bag of pennies here. And here they are. And you can buy as much with all of that as you can with $1.
What about nickels and dimes?
A nickel is the same as...
5 pennies.
Mm-hmm. And 1 dime is the same as...
10 pennies.
Can you only make a dime with pennies?
No. 5 pennies and 1 nickel are the same as 1 dime. Or 2 nickels are the same as 1 dime. 10 pennies, 1 dime, 2 nickels, all the same. Do you know what this is?
A quarter, the same as 25 pennies.
Or 3 nickels and 1 dime add up to a quarter.
And for this game, you'll need 100 pennies, 20 nickels, 10 dimes, 4 quarters. You also need 100 cards, and you put a number on each card, starting with 1 on the first card and 2 on the second card, all the way up to 100. That's all you need to play, and in a moment, I'll show you what happens next. Start. Now, I mixed up all the cards and I put them in the center. Then I turn the top one up. See, it's a 12. So the first person has to make a 12 with his toy money. Well, that's easy. 12 pennies make 12. Now the next person has to make 12 in a different way. Let's see. One dime and two pennies make 12. Oh, good. Clever Oswald. Now it's the next person's turn to try and find another way. Two nickels and two pennies. Yes. I think that's all the ways you can make 12. So the next person turns the next card over and starts again. Sometimes, when you get a very big number, you can go round and round and around, because big numbers can be made in so many different ways. If you want, you can keep score to see who can make the most ways. Now, let's see what the second card is. What will it be? Oh, 35. Well, that's easy. It's 3 dimes and 1 nickel make 35. 1 quarter and 1 dime make 35. Oh, and 1 quarter and 1 nickel and 5 pennies all make 35. Well, that must be all the ways. What? What's that? Meow. Oh, 1 quarter and 2 nickels. Yes, that's another way. But I'm sure there are no more ways to make 35. What? Oh, another one. Meow. Let's see. 3 groups of 10 and 5 more. Yes, that's 35, too. And why didn't I think of that one? Oh, my. Silly Oswald. Oh, I've got another one. I've got one. Look at this. Yes, here we are. 2 dimes and 2 nickels and 5 pennies. That also makes 35. Clever Oswald. Hooray for Oswald. Now, you try this one. There.